Sarah Jones from Pieceful Solutions, Riding and Training, and today we're going to be talking about Phase 3. Previously, we've discussed Phase 1 and Phase 2, which I will provide the links of both in the box below, which you can go back and review. But this exercise is great to develop seat, and there's a few different seats that I always teach my riders, whether they're English or Western, and today we have with us again Waverly, who's going to ride English for us, and Patty, who's going to be our Western rider. So as we go through, we'll start over here with Waverly, and I'm going to ask Waverly to go ahead and stand up in the stirrups, and I refer to this position as zipper. So what you want to think of as the rider is that your stirrup position, or your zipper position, I should say, is straight up and down. Her stirrup position, however, is going to be with her stirrup leather vertical, the whole of her stirrup towards 12 o'clock, and the bottom of her stirrup parallel to the ground. That becomes important so Waverly can remain stable and stand up in the saddle. Go ahead and sit for a second for me. A lot of times what riders do when they ride English is they don't come up far enough. So I really want her to be over the top of the pommel. So go ahead and stand up again. Super. And now she's going to go into a position which I call pocket. So she's going to come back as far as she can towards the back of the cantle. And I don't actually want her to sit. She's going to come back up to zipper and back to pocket. And back up to zipper where she's standing fully upright and back to pocket. Now, one of the things that's very important is as she goes up to zipper, as we've talked about previously, I want to make sure that she's stable. So she's going to have to snowplow, there you go, just a little bit more. And that's going to make her more stable because she's going to get her internal hip rotation, which is in turn going to lock in her leg. Go ahead, back to pocket again and up to zipper. Now what I'm going to ask her to do is come into what I call light seat. So light seat is something that you want to do for any horse that you're really warming up, young horses, when you're asking a horse to lift the back in any collected work, it's very important that you don't just sit on the horse's back. So I'm going to ask Waverly to go halfway in between her zipper and pocket and hover. Okay, and I want her to get as low as she can in that position, but not come back towards the back of the saddle and not come forward towards the front of the saddle. So she's basically hovering in that position, and that position, it's tough, right? Yes. So she's actually supporting her body weight through her leg, which most riders don't necessarily do. It's a lot easier. I'm going to push your heels down. Go back to the old way that you used to do when you came to me riding. They can brace with their heels and pull with their hands, and that puts the horse in the motorboat position and the rider in the water skiing position. So basically she can balance between here and here. What I'm asking her to do, yes, is bring the heels up and level, bring the heels out and away, internally rotate the hips and stay in that light seat. So go ahead back up to zipper. She's gonna fully stand up. She's gonna come back to pocket. She's gonna come in between the dead center of the two and light seat. And now I'm going to ask her to go into full seat or three-point position. She's going to sit in the middle of the two. But what's incredibly important at this point in time is that go head up to zipper, back to pocket, light seat, sit in full seat and rock back. This is what everybody tends to do. So they go ahead and they rock back onto the back of their seat bones. Now if she had a flashlight that was pointing down straight through her seat bones, it would be pointing towards Stryker's front legs, and that's not what we want. We want her pelvis to remain in the middle of the two so that if she had flashlights on her seat bones, they would be going straight down through the horse's belly. Back up to zipper, pocket, light seat, full seat, and the last position that she's going to go to is two-point, which is essentially pocket. She's going to go right back into that position. She's going to push her heels out and away. This, in turn, is going to make her stable. Come a little bit here and a little bit there. There you go. Okay. At this point in time, now she's very stable in order to be able to jump. She can change her position from going to two-point to light seat to full seat. And what I do with my riders at this point in time is I speed it up so that they're able to change within a stride. A lot of times you're changing your seat on the fly. So we're going to do it a little bit faster. Ready? Zipper, pocket, light seat, full seat, two-point. Zipper, pocket, light seat, full seat, two-point. Super. Okay? So we're going to go through those exercises step by step. The rider goes through them. They get them a little bit in their muscle memory, and then we speed up the process. Now we're going to go ahead and look at Patty. So Patty is our Western rider. And again, I go through the same process with my Western riders just as much as I go through with my English riders. It's a big fallacy that Western riders ride on their pockets all the time, and they have that couch potato seat where they're actually digging their seat bones down into the horse's back. If you were to think when you bring your horse out, the horse is already hollow. You have to warm them up and get them stretching through their back. If we sit with our seat bones heavy, then it's going to act like two bones that are digging into the horse's spine on either side, and that in turn is going to make the horse hollow out. So we want to make sure that we support our own body weight, we lift our seat just slightly, and that we're bringing that light seat and support through our legs so that the horse is able to raise up underneath of us. We're inviting them to that position. So Patty, go ahead up into zipper and back to pocket. She's going to come all the way back. Super. Light seat. Yep. Full seat. And 2 point. Elwood, zipper, pocket, light seat, full seat, 2 point. Super, zipper, pocket, light seat, full seat, 2 point. And the only criticism that I would say to Patty, bring your heel out and away a little bit more. Little bit more internal hip rotation, and now try. So sometimes what I'll do for my riders is as you're building up stability, core, muscle, I'll go ahead and add that resistance out where I'd like her foot to be. I'll ask her to go ahead and rise up. That's zipper, pocket, light seat, full seat, 2 point. Good. Zipper, pocket, light seat, full seat, 2 point. Super. So you can see how we go through these exercises. Again, I teach all of my riders these exercises, and it helps to make them more stable. It helps to give them confidence. A lot of my riders come from terrible accidents, things that have happened to them previously, and the first thing I do is I go ahead and break all of their riding down, and we teach from scratch to make them feel more confident and more stable in the saddle. So I hope these exercises have helped. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me at tarajones7@yahoo.com. Hope to see you on the next one. Thanks a lot, everybody. Have a great day.